of the gameplay here, of the tournament here on Grand Final Set 6WX from the Losers Bracket. We'll be facing LOF Blue in the Winners Bracket from a rematch from Winners Finals. If you guys are enjoying yourself, don't forget to share this out with your friends on Twitter. Let them know we are here. Hashtag Philly Smash, we are here. Even though, you know, the last Philly defendant is Philly's new number one PR, 6WX. But, you know, let's see what happens.
Okay. Can you pull it out for the city?
This man just went for the down smash again. Like, remember this move. Understand that this is what caused your downfall.
Yes.
Just just a friendly
just
reminder.
Put it in your head.
Friendly reminder.
Yep.
I mean, sometimes that mental game could just be all you need to take the game.
I'm fully aware. Yeah, the stream knows I had a bad loss today.
That was a raw shadow ball right to right to 6WX.
Okay. Oh wow, I don't like fishing for that up smash too much. It is a lot less punishable than it used to be, but you don't want to get predictable with that.
See, what's happening here, what I see happening is that Blue is more so just going for the standard punishes. He goes for a shadow ball and then goes for his up smash. He goes for a down tilt and tries to get to a fair for an up smash. But what 6WX is doing right now is fading back anytime he's hit. He's not allowing Mewtwo to get any of those follow-ups. He may get a down tilt or whatever, but that's kind of, look at him, fades right back.
Yeah, more focused on getting stage control back. Playing through the disadvantage state. That's not going to kill.
That was a nice idea, but I guess Blue just saw that one.
I don't know if he did it on purpose. I thought he was trying to just double jump and back air from there. That's not going to kill
be
either.
Not it.
No, it's stale now.
I don't think
the next one could.
He only used it once, though.
Yeah, but that's enough to stale it once.
Nah, I don't think it's that bad. Oh, God.
Know. Sonic's heavier than you give him credit for.
I know, I didn't say Sonic was light at all.
No, but it's, I don't know. Typically 130 is when that move starts to kill consistently. So.
The
back
light
air trades with the shadow ball.
The light shadow ball. And the kick is going right through it. Blue, after having a good lead of it, just lost control.
Yeah, that being said, he's like a fair away from taking this stock. But 6WX also hasn't been like falling for fair at all.
I think 6WX is starting to understand that he needs to make sure he is out of the range of Mewtwo's up smash at all times, although he caught the fair and the stock is gone and I don't know what to do. We had 30% and 6WX kind of slipped a little bit there. Just a little bit though. Mm-hmm. I've never seen Blue use up B, like the teleport, to get back to the stage.
Oh, he hasn't had to. The platform's been on his side.
No, I know. It's just one of those things. Was like it could be a mix-up, but he hasn't used it like once.
Yeah, especially because information's out there now from Beefy Smash users. If you teleport from above, you can't get two framed. You just come out of it, grabbing the ledge without it going through the two frame animation. So it's free.
All right, down throw from Mewtwo just kind of threw Sonic right off stage there, which is always good to throw your opponent off stage because it automatically puts them on defense.
Yes.
Right now, Mewtwo's
it forces either an edgeguard situation or a ledge situation where you can just kind of pick options. You don't have to worry about like five specific options that they can go for instead of just
like
any
Sonic
other
charging
time.
Spin dash or Mewtwo trying to go for a down tilt.
Oh,
holy!
What?
How?
He just ran through it.
I'm pretty sure he just used minimize.
That's not even fair.
I'm pretty sure that was minimize.
That is. Why does Sonic get minimized?
In the back though, that's gonna be it.
Yep. Not quite.
I think he might have waited a little too much with the double pummels.
Yeah, just gave him enough time to DI it right.
Yep. All right,
that's why I say pummeling's overrated. Don't give him the chance to DI. Wow.
In a situation, if you don't have the opportunity to KO, then yeah, get your pummel in like one or two. I know Mario can pummel every 40 to 50% depending on their mashing.
Yeah.
But that's just one of the things you can't do. Well, wow, that back air just solidly smacking
him. That didn't look like it should have hit. Like, I like barely connected on the edge of him. Hitboxes are weird.
Smash 4 is a funky game.
Yeah, Hungerbox had a tweet about like acronyms for all the games, and Smash 4 was a salty memes and strange hitboxes. Oh, side B has iframes?
Once again,
that's awesome.
Wait, side B? Oh, it does.
That's how it worked.
Yeah. Well then there you go. That's a little silly.
No, don't nerf. Anyway, we got a Ryu switch. After a victory.
There we go. Sorry about that, guys. But all right, here we go. So once again, he gets a victory and he goes to Ryu. This has to be for practice. Or maybe he really does feel like this matchup will be better for him. I mean, he is a heavier character.
Yeah.
He does have the focus attack, even though it won't help him on the...
Maybe he prefers it on Battlefield. He did this on Battlefield both times. I didn't even think about that.
I don't know, possibly, but he just won. But yeah, that could be the case. That could be the case. The Canopy Bowser was like, all right, I'm gonna go Ryu.
Yeah, that makes sense. You can ledge cancel Shoryuken to get to the top platform, and a true Shoryuken will kill super early off the top.
That was a wall.
Especially on Mewtwo, actually, because weight and fall speed, he'll die off the top really fast. Right, just interrupting your charge.
Right, charging Shadow Ball. Oh, and the Shadow Ball interrupted, not canceling it in time.
Oh, okay, nice. Covering ledge with confusion.
Yo, that was kind of trippy.
He just sidesteps that. Oh, wow.
Whoa.
That doesn't kill.
I wish that KO, because that was beautiful.
Yeah. I mean, it only makes sense that you just kind of... Wow. The meaty back air.
I don't know if you're supposed to be able to cancel the focus attack after... Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, after the last attack comes out.
Yeah. All right, so we're all up even again. Ooh.
Oh, up tilt is one of the best starting moves of in Ryu's repertoire.
You bet. Up tilt, and he can get like three or four pretty easily.
Up tilt leads into down tilt, leads into side smash, leads into nair, leads into dare, leads into combos, into Shoryuken, which can KO at like 80% depending on the character.
Honestly, Mewtwo could kill as early as like 65.
But yeah, that's what I'm saying, like, depending on the character. I was just naming an average number.
Right. But this is no average. Oh, okay. Focus is through the. That's another thing. Focus attack, actually, the invincibility on that starts on frame one. So if you're getting comboed, like, that's like the perfect option for unless they're using like a bunch of multi-hit moves.
Ooh, trading the dare to Mewtwo's dash attack.
Oh, okay. I don't know if he's trying to ledge cancel that. But, oh, just throws out the Shadow Ball, predicting the jump. Oh man,
that was dangerous because
that was never gonna work because the Shoryuken always sharks on battlefield.
Both characters being at kill percent. Actually, no, I feel like Ryu might have a little bit more on him.
Oh, okay.
You gotta be wary
of
that.
Nice up air shark.
Like Mewtwo does so well.
Okay.
So Mewtwo does so well with sharking on the stage. You have to respect that more. Getting caught by the up smash, and once again, he goes to Ryu and loses the game.
It's sending a bad. I don't know. I don't agree with it.
I just want to ask him why he's making that switch. It has to be because he wants to try Ryu on Battlefield more so than Sonic. I can't think of anything else.
I know it's the only one that would make sense.
He goes right back to Sonic.
Well, yeah, he probably banned Battlefield. But well, actually, it wouldn't have mattered because he can't pick the stage that he went on. So. Yeah, let's go to Omega Gower Plane. I'm down with that.
I mean, yeah, I'm fine with Gower Plane. But our final destination is what it's going to be. There's a 6WS counter pick, and Sonic, you already know, Sonic loves any stage about platforms.
Exactly. Just give him free reign of mobility. Ability to access any point of the stage at any
time.
Right, so he missed it there, you know, after I said he, like, hits it every time. But, solid.
I'm going for a hard mosquito.
Never forget him. All right, fair. Okay, he's still behind. Good power shield. Okay, here's the thing. He's waiting for air dodges to punish, but Mewtwo's air dodge is already so hard to punish.
Yeah, not to mention
that option isn't working out well.
Not to mention when you air dodge, you can't even tell where Mewtwo was coming from.
That and his hurtbox.
I'm sorry, where Mewtwo is going. Excuse me.
Yeah, that and for the frames that he's coming out of it, his hurtbox is the size of a pinhole. Because he just kind of like warps into it and then out.
He minimizes.
Exactly.
Oh,
Mewtwo doesn't get minimized, does he?
No. I feel like he does, actually.
Maybe in, like, Gen 1 when it was a TM.
Possibly.
Not sure.
That's a little fun fact. Let us know, guys. I feel like he does get in Gen 1, but let us know. That nair, one of Mewtwo's best-looking moves, I'll say that.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty cool. Oh, wow. Yep, caught the jump.
Wow.
Up smash perfectly read the jump there.
Right now, 6WX looking a little falling back here right now.
Yeah, a little bit. Ooh, okay. Lands with him there.
Who rolled right past the Shadow Ball. Great timing on that, allowing him to not mute you off stage. But he still has to claim the stocker with no rage.
Oh, wow, he just grabbed him right out of the spin dash. That was pretty.
And with no rage, it's not going to be that easy for him. Look at him. He's, like, just dropping
that. That's a good out-of-shield option.
Blue is just dropping that nair. I'm sorry, that dare. Down smash. Excuse me.
Yes.
God. I'm not going to commentate.
I mean, he's just trying to let him know. This is always there.
There we go. He finally did it back to the stage.
Oh, wow. There we go.
I guess that's why he never did it, because Sonic can just punish you heavy. The homing attack.
Homing attack kill. Okay. I think there's two common catchphrases for Smash 4. Where's my jump? and that killed?
I mean, you're right.
Yeah.
Right now, the damage being racked up back in CWX's favor, 43 to 42, and never mind, 43 to 58.
Okay.
Well, dash attack. Blue is
that's 11 damage.
Blue is looking a little hungry right now.
Yeah, that's a very unsafe move just throw out in the neutral. All right, drags him down with fair. Okay, good air dodge pass. Throws out the F smash. That's actually really safe. Just kind of covering an approach off. Oh wow, the falling fair is enough to get him. The Sonic's hurtbox gets pretty low to the ground when he spin dashes. Oh, misses the up smash.
I feel like 6WX is being way too aggressive.
Yeah, I agree. Like, he doesn't have to be the aggressor in any of these situations, really. Ooh.
No, okay. He doesn't. And yet, he's just constantly making sure he's putting out a hitbox. But normally, like, he'll
fall. Oh, wow. Like, stalling and getting the back air?
Normally, he'll be falling back and just trying to get his opponent. I'm sorry, get his opponent to make a mistake like he was doing against Vash. This time, he's really trying to take the fight with 6WX, and I'm not sure. Maybe he's just fearful of the Shadow Boss.
Possible.
But it's like every single KO and all the damage he's taken has been from a miss.
Not gonna do it.
That was just a really raw. Come on, dude. Oh, in the back air.
The back air just edges him out. Come on.
Catching him from the whiff on Shadow Ball. 6WX now taking it to a 2-0. Looking to reset this bracket.
You bet.
It was in his favor the entire time until Blue just whiffed that Shadow Ball. I don't know why he threw it. I probably would have pocketed it for more opportunity.
If anything, you should have like jumped and launched it.
I wouldn't have thrown the Shadow Ball anytime where Mewtwo was actually in the air trying to approach. Like, if you got the throw, then throw that to follow up.
Yeah. Shadow Ball inherently applies pressure. It basically means that you have a trump card. Yeah. I have a very powerful move that I can punish anything with at any distance.
I just love the animation of that nair.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet.
Yo, can we get that to be Mewtwo's smash pose? It's just gorgeous. Yo, can we hit up first four figures?
Yeah, not the generic, I have a fist back and a hand out.
That's an okay one, but I mean, like...
I know, but so many characters have it.
I need first four figures to make a figure off of Mewtwo's nair and smash.
Yeah, that'd be cool. I'd be down, depending on price.
But then again, we need Mewtwo from Pokken and Smash. Actually, no, we don't.
Why? Is he like the best character in that game?
He is. He's like Sheik on day one.
Okay. Yeah. That says everything I need to know. Oh, wow. Misses the tech, but... Oh, wow. But Mewtwo's recovery is just so good.
Yeah, really floaty, long distance. Allowing him to cover that up. I don't even think he was expecting to eat in the tech right there.
Maybe he just knew he didn't need to. Must be nice.
Wow, he just up smashed right through the spring.
Yeah.
Can't say it was a bad idea.
I mean, that move is significantly safer since the buffs that it got, but I do feel like Blue, like, throws it out a lot. Oh!
That's
just
unfortunate.
The raw up smash.
When you are caught
up, landing.
When you are caught up on that platform, you are at your opponent's mercy because they can just back at you. They can up smash you.
They can just apply a ton of shield pressure for free with a lot of areas.
Exactly. Then if you try to jump out of it, a lot of attacks have an extended hitbox through the platform.
Yeah. Oh, wow! Oh. The up air off the top. Solid.
Hard challenge.
Well, not only that, but the shield dropping is so freaking hard to do. Oh, well, gets the footstool.
All right, here we go. The footstool shenanigans.
Shield looking pretty low. Now, this is when you should be aggressive on him. When you have a low shield and you know that they can't take a defensive option.
Yeah.
Other than, like, a roll, which is predictable. Yeah. Right. Ooh. Okay. Just the raw down air to land with.
I mean, they can also sidestep.
Yeah. One is, though, they can't shield. They have to pick an offensive option. A lot more punishable.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
Poking him with the tail. Catch his tail.
Yo, call it a tail whip?
Tail whip? I think that's low sweep is down tilt. He actually gets low sweep.
Wait, Mewtwo gets low sweep?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, it's still tail whip.
Okay. It's the fair.
Oh, stage mite?
Oh, he
missed the tech, but he's good.
He's not good.
We have
a reset.
Where's the up B?
I'm not sure.
What happened to the up B?
No, you don't just lose your up B. Maybe he knew that it wouldn't come back.
No, he was there. He could have come back. I think he could have came back.
I don't know, possibly. I mean, I lost to Blue because I misjudged the teleport distance and I couldn't make it back, so.
That's wild.
I don't know.
Well, all right, Blue.
6WX resets it, so. Grand Final set 2, 6WX versus Blue. Going back to Starterville.
was it? Blue is going to have to figure out what exactly he did wrong there. He took the set the first time, albeit in the game five situation.
Yeah.
But he took the set the first time in one of his finals. He needs to figure out exactly what he's been doing wrong and try to apply that, reapply that to take these next three games.
Oh, someone in the chat saying I think he side beat by accident. He couldn't act out of it fast enough. Because he did, like, kind of move to the left, like, really quickly.
I mean, I thought he did that purposely.
I don't think he'd ever do that purposely.
My nice.
Good. No, because if you get a net. Oh, yeah, that's actually true. Because you wouldn't.
It's horizontal movement. And you actually jump up a little bit.
You do have a net. There's like a net neutral in terms of verticality. So.
Oh, well. Maybe it was a mistake. But right now, 6WX is just playing trying to apply a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
But.
The blue's stuffing him out. Pretty good. Covering options. Got Shadow Ball online.
Oh, he tried to throw it. I think they actually took out the charge. Yep, the Shadow Ball charge is gone. Stuffed it out.
Okay. Oh, wow.
He tried.
The back throw would have killed.
He tried.
With how far it was back. He read the air dodge, but he didn't catch the DI.
That's Blue's, that's his calling card right now on this matchup, is these hard reads with these smashes from Mewtwo.
Yeah.
Whether it's a down smash or a up smash. I don't think he's used a side smash yet, like, at all.
Which is weird, because that's, like, the safest one, at least on Shield.
I mean, but you gotta try to catch a Sonic on that.
Yeah, true enough. Yeah, if you mistime that, that's a free spin dash. With how 6WX just keeps loading it up and just waiting for a reaction from there.
Wow, the fact that his spin dash beat out the Nair, attack that covers Mewtwo, and sat
his
entire body.
Perfect pivot grab just catches him right out of the spin. That was beautiful.
You hear that sound from his pivot dashes?
Yeah, that doesn't. Just, he's just, floating. That should make a sound.
Oh, fourth throw. Oh, no. Going for a down throw. This is not Mewtwo off stage.
Yeah, his up throw isn't going to kill yet, so. I feel like he it won't, like, get any combos off, so he wants to keep that fresh.
6WX is showing
good
records.
Up throw.
Showing records about. He said, abandon. He said, yes.
Oh, no.
What? He fast fell way too hard. And I don't think he was expecting that.
That's unfortunate. He's having.
Yeah, that was a loss.
Up these.
That was loss of a good stock he could have been using to rack up damage. And now with these low percent, pretty much whenever, if you're facing the Sonic and low percent, expect to get comboed.
Yeah. A lot of his moves just kind of lead into each other perfectly.
How do you even catch a Sonic who has, like these options are just amazing. He can avoid any projectile you throw, and then he instantly spin dashes, and now he's an offensive presence to you after avoiding your attack.
Well, from what I can tell, how you beat these kinds of Sonics, you gotta predict what option they're gonna go for, but 6WX is just mixing it up so well.
I mean, if prediction is your best bet, then it's like.
That's part of why I think he's one or two in the game. Ooh.
Alright, Blue taking a huge amount of damage since that homing attack almost screwing him up. But taking a huge amount of damage now at a 60% deficit.
Okay, I guess you can air dodge if you're fast enough. Wow, the back air kills.
The back air is going to be it.
6WX has a lot of momentum right now. A lot of momentum.
That slide little smile from him. I don't know if you saw that. He was like, alright, we got this. Yeah. But man, like, Blue looking a little frazzled.
Yeah.
Trying to figure this out.
It's been a while. I think it's he hasn't won since he beat Ryu.
Right.
6WX has won every game with Sonic.
All right, so we go to Battlefield,
and he doesn't
go to Ryu.
Yeah, I think he wants to win now.
Let's try to figure out exactly what it is that he's deciding to do with this decision, because he didn't.
We get to interview him. We'll just have to ask that.
He swapped from Battlefield twice.
Yeah.
Well, he swapped from Battlefield twice. And I'm sorry, he went to Battlefield. This time he went to Ryu. Excuse me about that.
But not this time. Okay. And like, frankly, it's still working out just well for him. He's got a, you know, huge percent lead on him. Okay. Gets the up air.
And the up air. Going to reset it. He wanted to reset it from that platform. He was feeling. He was like, yo, I am ready to up B again. But unfortunately, Blue faded back.
He punished the air dodge.
Following him right over with a fair. Knock him in the blast zone.
Oh, wow.
Only taking 70%.
Only 26% on him.
6WX.
I think he's pretty much adapted to him. He's on a roll completely. Oh, wow. Sonic's on a roll.
Wow.
I like it.
I mean, that's the entirety of his game. That's at least 60% of his game.
Yeah.
Going for the confusion. I think he's just trying to switch it up at that moment.
Yeah, disable. That move's actually...
Disable, you're right.
Yeah, that move's actually safer than you think. But I don't know if it catches Sonic out of the spin. Yeah, it definitely does not. So don't go for that when he's...
I don't think that. Oh, wow.
That looked like a melee ledge cancel.
He fell with the Nair. He rolls with the Nair. Kind of wild. What was Mewtwo's Nair in Melee?
I think it was the same kind of move. He made this move like meh, and like it still kind of zapped you a bunch. It wasn't nearly as good, like most of Mewtwo.
Well, what is it right now? Like blue, like right now we have 6WX who just reset it on LOF Blue after beating him in Winners Finals. That's like Triple Z. We ended up the same situation.
Oh wow. Okay. All right. Getting some up air percent. Oh, okay. That's actually a pretty safe option for if 6WX is above him. Might as well go for it if he like lets go of his shield too early or something like that. Oh, but not there. Definitely not a safe option there. Oh man, 6WX coming back with the two stock. He's one game away from taking grand finals from loser's side.
That may have been a very just reactionary situation where he's threw the up smash out just to get the kill. Like maybe he's getting frustrated. Cause that was possibly. Like you said, like Blue was a really fantastic player. I'm sure he knows that was the bad option, but maybe he was just desperate. I don't want to say desperate. It's probably the best bad word to use, but I mean he's struggling right now. This is game point for Circa 6WX. Sticking with Sonic, even on Battlefield, so I guess that Ryu phase of his life may have been over.
What is this music? Like, this is like not appropriate for like, the actual final game.
I actually think it's great music. It's great music.
Okay.
But I actually feel like, was it Blue? Maybe should have swapped to any of his other characters.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, Blue maybe should have swapped to any of his other characters. He does have the Charizard. He also has a Sonic of his own.
I would not go with that Sonic Ditto.
I was going to say that nobody wants the Sonic Ditto.
Against maybe the best Sonic in the world. So.
But I do know that Blue has, I know that Blue has a plethora of amount of characters. Mewtwo doesn't seem to be cutting it right now. So, I don't
know. Nice, Nair to grab.
He's just determined to win this matchup with Mewtwo.
Maybe. The comeback would be epic, that's for sure.
I mean, the damage is right now in his favor. Was that about 50% lead right now? 40% lead, 30%. Okay, now 40%. Yeah. Back lead on 6WX right now.
Solid.
Has to claim the next three games to even take this. And once again,
oh, wow. The spin shot to fair.
Those hard reads he's making with the side smashes, they are not cutting it for him.
Not at all.
They worked in the game one. 6WX is not allowing that in this set.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, wow.
Two frame.
But, like, he didn't even make a grab animation.
This is...
I don't know if Blue was holding back just so he could respond to, like, fair or something. Oh, wow. The up smash will take it, though.
This is tournament life for Blue. He needs to make sure that all of his moves right now are pristine. Do not make any mistakes. Do not allow Sonic to get at any situation. And make sure that your movement stay as erratic as possible. Take opportunity of every situation that you have. Just like he did with the down tilt to the fair. Carry Sonic off stage. Make sure you keep him in a situation where he's not comfortable.
Oh, wow. He read that, but it just barely missed the execution. It's late. It's the Nair. Good. He's not quite dead.
He's perfect shield. Oh, he just ran across the stage.
I agree with that. He risked jumping and getting some momentum back. Anytime off stage when you're not edge guarding, it was wasted time completely. Sonic can regain stage control in an instant. Okay. Actually, no, I like what he's doing. These shadow balls are preventing him from like spin dash stalling. Because they will hit them if he just
but the intervals in between is gonna allow Sonic to approach, so I really don't like maybe once or twice just for like a mix up.
Yeah. Wow.
He tried to get the follow up off the missed tech.
Oh no!
Oh no! The size, the up smash.
6WX is just—he's always ready to punish that up smash. Now he knows that Blue's kind of thirsty for it. That's like his go-to kill option when it should be up throw at higher percents.
But I mean, like, does he have any other options from the up smash? I honestly wouldn't even go for it anymore.
For the two frame, but doesn't quite get it. Oh, called out the roll that didn't come. Oh, gets the back air.
Again, every move he's been making with these side smashes has been like real hard call. Okay, shadow call. Not a critical hit. Not taking that stock yet.
All right, I had this discussion.
No!
It's not going to do it.
Okay. I don't know what that sound was, by the way. I apologize. I was just nervous. Oh, okay. This is a real dangerous situation. If he can get a grab, I'm pretty sure Mewtwo's going to take this. Pocket that shadow ball. Pocket that shadow ball. Pocket the shadow ball.
Please it's
pocket
very the shadow obvious. Ball. He has all pocket the space shadow ball. In the world.
He doesn't have to approach you.
Yeah.
Actually, no, he does have to approach him.
Oh, okay. I like what he was trying to do there, but I think he just was slightly off with his spacing because that could have covered the platform, essentially.
Oh, he went for the grab.
All right, that's good.
I don't think the up throw is
it will on a platform, but I don't.
That pivot grab, Blue is on the board. Pivot grab and the up throw is going to take him into this game.
We're not dead yet.
Not dead yet, but right now he has to win the next two games that that 6WX sets up. These next two games are in his favor. If even if he loses game four, he still gets to pick the next stage.
True.
Not to mention, he has the lead. He has to stay ahead no matter what. He lets his opponent catch up in between matches, and he just hit the lead again. So, I mean, that matchup, I feel like, well, first of all, Blue is getting really impatient.
Yes.
I've seen that.
I think he was playing a lot more patiently at the end of the last game. He was going for the right option with the pivot grab to counter the approach. So.
Yeah, I think he told himself mentally down at the end. He's just like, okay, this is my last situation, like last hit. If he hits me with back air, I'm dead. So he really just slowed down, got himself with the pivot grab. Really nice and fast option for him that allowed him to get the KO. He needs to keep applying that same mentality. Don't get too aggressive. Stop calling out moves with the up smash and the down smash and just play a solid, effective, basic
especially here on
game.
FD.
A basic fundamental game.
Okay. Because FD, you can't just throw F smash out. There's no platforms for him to catch a landing with.
I mean, I don't think Blue has thrown out a single F smash.
Up smash. Did I say F smash?
Oh, I thought I heard you say F smash.
Okay, that's fine.
But yeah, like...
Those iframes come into play.
All right, invincibility frames.
I can't believe that move has iframes. It feels like that's way too good on that.
That's kind of wild. Oh! Ooh, that was a hard chase. Okay. Then he put the spring down there to cover any offense or punish Blue.
Exactly. Because I find that, like, less good Sonics will go for a spin dash, and then if you're sealed, they'll just jump away. I mean, usually that's a free aerial to punish, if you can read that. But he just put the spring out there to cover any sort of jump option that he was going to go for.
There it is.
Just like that.
Like that, I'm telling you, spin dash and the spring is so, just so safe. It's kind of...
Okay.
Woo!
Put that in a position that he couldn't air dodge it, though, because he was going to land with it, and that would not have been ideal.
Throwing a shadow ball. I wonder if there's any way...
Got to make you think about it.
Right now...
He has to establish that he will throw it.
Right now, what Blue needs to figure out is how he can use that shadow ball. Because every time he does it, he doesn't perfect shield it. He doesn't sidestep it. He always jumps it.
Yeah.
He needs to figure out how he can use that shadow ball.
It looks like it just like sine waved over him pretty much.
He needs to figure out how to use that shadow ball to throw 6WX off and just allow him to get a KO. Like,
yes.
Whether he has to throw it close range or anything like that. Actually, close range probably is a good idea.
Stuffs it out. He doesn't get the animation off to launch it. Ooh, careful. That F smash can 2-frame.
I thought you said that that he can't 2-frame Mewtwo's up B.
No. For a teleport up B's, and it's mainly Zelda, Mewtwo, Palutena, and Sheik, they have to be above the ledge. Because the 2-frame animation comes from when you have the ledge here, and then you're coming at it from some angle. But there's no animation for it coming from the top.
That's strange.
So if you teleport it from the top, you'll just go right into the normal animation. There's no 2-frame window.
That is strange.
There's a new Beefy Smash Dudes video about it. That would explain it better.
I'm actually starting to get annoyed by that now.
Yeah, he's like timing it perfectly just to counter out the shadow ball.
Alright, going for no foot though. Nope. And that's why I like that he didn't even try to challenge him on that one.
Yeah.
Getting your shield.
Okay. I'm glad he didn't throw it out because that actually was legitimately his best shot to get a F smash read. I said F smash.
Alright, avoiding the fair with Mewtwo's confusion.
Okay, too much spot dodge there.
Oh, he went for the fair.
Oh my god! We don't tech those.
Woo! I don't think he was. He went for the fair and whiffed it. I thought, like, I bet you he was guessing, like, okay, I can get back to the stage. Once again, Blue is back on his tournament stock. He has to take out these next two stocks in order to survive.
Yeah, right now fair is probably your best bet.
And right now 6WX is running away with this.
Catches the roll. You can't really roll when they spin dash at you. That it covers like every option.
That's not gonna do it. No.
Not enough rage. That would need to be like 135 for that to kill.
That's not what you want to be right now. Back air is going to hurt you, especially with all that rage that Sonic has.
Ooh,
up air
nice
is going
air.
To do it.
All right,
52% on him.
And he's got Shadow Ball on deck. All right, spin shot up air. Ooh, just kind of spin dashes right over it. It's a fair. Oh wow, he's being so tricky with his movement. I would hate to fight
Blue.
This.
being uncharacteristically aggressive right now compared to the rest of this matchup.
Oh, man.
Very nice roll.
Yeah.
That was just smooth. Like, I know it was just a roll. I mean, I understand that was just a roll, but that was a buttery roll.
Yeah.
That was, I'm pretty sure that was a Golden Corral roll. And you know how good those things are. These rolls?
Yo, Golden Corral roll is actually OP.
That was a beautiful roll. Oh, God. 6WX is on the attack. Has Mewtwo, has Blue above him.
He's absolutely at kill percent from basically every kill move 6WX has.
Yeah, he wants to be careful. Don't take any more. I think he just went to go show the shadow ball in front of him. Whoa.
Careful.
This is a dangerous situation. All right.
Up back air.
Back
air jump.
Is going to do it.
6WX will take it over LOF Blue.
A very strong and sturdy handshake between the two competitors, but a very good performance from 6WX taking it from Loser's Bracket in, was it 6-2 over LOF Blue to take this game. That was
exactly 6-1 with Sonic. So
that was just exactly, and the games that he lost was the game that he lost were Ryu. So I don't know why he was using Ryu. I'm definitely gonna ask him.
Yeah.
But I'm glad that he did not do that the next two times that Battlefield was chosen.
Definitely.
Congratulations to 6WX coming back from Loser's Bracket after losing to LOF Blue in Winners Finals to take Weaver Bears number 32. LOF Blue takes second, and Vash takes third.
Yeah.
With SSB Matt, Luck taking fourth place here tonight.
Yes.
So definitely our top four players, an intense tournament. A lot of great plays as well.
Oh, absolutely.
Like, I definitely enjoyed everybody.
Also significantly less hot. That's always appreciated.
Well, I mean, last week was an anomaly. Things just kind of went weird. It was a hot day, 93 attendance. I'm sure Brotherly Love tomorrow is going to have a lot of people out here. Hopefully it's at least 50, but we'll have to see what happens. But that is going to be the end, unless you want to interview somebody. I know I have to get out of here, and I'm sure a lot of other people.
That's fine. I'm going to be at Brotherly Love tomorrow, so I want to get some sleep.
There you go. All right, man. So we are all going to get out of here. That is the end of the tournament. Thank you all so much for hanging out with us. If you guys enjoyed yourself, don't forget to follow Brothers Calamity. We will be live tomorrow beginning at 11:45 a.m. with Brotherly Love 7. We're going to have Melee and Smash 4 on deck for you guys. And we're going to be streaming Melee singles and Smash 4 singles as well. So make sure you guys, there's the slot right there. Show your love to that one. Melee Low Tiers begins at 11:45. Smash 4
Eight-man free-for-alls
begins at 12:15 p.m. Those are the fun stuff.
Guess I'm coming early.
Then the seriousness happens when Melee 1v1 begins on stream at 1:30 p.m. along with Smash 4 doubles at 1:30 p.m. And then once Melee singles is finished, we're going to be moving the stream over and finishing with Smash 4 1v1s that will start after the Smash 4 2v2 ends. So we have a lot of content and tournament and Smash ready for you guys. So if you guys want to hang out with us, follow us on Twitter, follow us on Twitch, check out the YouTube channel for any of the fantastic matches you guys may have missed out on today in this tournament. And believe me, there were a lot of fantastic matches.
Absolutely.
But